Our correspondent Jody Cohen spoke with Ellie Carmen, senior research scholar at the International Institute for Counterterrorism and a former advisor to the Israeli Ministry of Defense.
Ellie, can you outline for us what Iran's current capabilities are? We've heard about 60% uranium enrichment, 90% uranium metal. What do these all mean?
The Iranians have today the capability to produce in 2 months uranium for one bomb. They have 3,000 kilograms of enriched uranium. From this, 120 is 60% pure, which means that with 200% they can build the bomb. And they have now probably preparing to enrich at 90%, which the percentage for the bomb itself.
And what do you think about Iran's claim that they say that the nuclear program is for civilian purposes and not for achieving a nuclear bomb?
First of all, Israel has brought the archives of the nuclear program, which was clearly a military program. They stopped it because of the threat of the United States. And we also understand that the missiles that they are producing to hit 2,000 kilometers far is not for conventional bombs or missiles. It is for nuclear bombs.
Does Iran actually have this capability now, or are its claims for strengthening its negotiating position at the Iran talks in Vienna, do you think?
The two of them, on the one hand, they are already threatening the United States if they don't go to the negotiations and they stop the sanctions, then can they continue the program? And as I said, according to the evaluation, in 2 months they have the enrichment, enriched uranium. On the other hand, they are prepared to be on the brink. They don't want at this moment, at least, to appear as a nuclear state. And this is a game that the Iranians are playing for a long time.
And is this some sort of game of chicken, almost like who will blink first? Do you think it will be the U.S. with waiving sanctions or Iran with pausing its nuclear activities and allowing in the inspectors?
I'm quite pessimistic because the United States is much weaker because it has retreated from the Middle East militarily, has lost in Afghanistan and has withdrawn in a very shameful way, and they didn't arrive with the North Koreans to any agreement. So the Iranians are clearly sure that the United States cannot impose their will on Iran itself.
Finally, if Iran does pause its nuclear activities, how can global powers be sure that it won't restart them again in the future?
It's very, very difficult. You need a very sensitive intelligence. And at the moment, at least, the United Nations is not controlling what happens on the ground. We saw it according to the last report by the IAEA. And therefore, there will be always some kind of tension. If there is an agreement, indeed, the Iranians are respecting it. As I said, also, there is today information by our Minister of Defense that they already have prepared to enrich to 90%, which means that they want to go nuclear.
Thank you, Ellie Carmon, for breaking that all down for us. Certainly high stakes in the days ahead with the restart of the talks in Vienna. This is Jody Cohen for WEON, World is One.
WEON now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.